Lord, we long to see your mighty power, like you once moved when you walked the shores of Galilee. Lord, we pray that you would just send forth your power once again in our generation to our people. Lord, that people would be saved and delivered and healed like you once did. You are God and you don't change. Lord, we pray that you would anoint us with your power to see the captive set free. Amen.
Let us see the mighty power of the God still alive. Let us see in words and wonders like these so long ago. Please truly fix your eyes on him as Jesus passes by. Touch him, you will never be the same. Let us see the mighty power of the God still alive. Let us see
Mount Zion would like to thank you for joining us in one of our worship services. Worship is one of the greatest treasures given to the church. The thought of worship is really fairly simple. It means to adore, to bow before, or to revere. The book of Revelation shows us that at this very moment, all of heaven is worshiping and bowing, holiness and absolute reverence surrounding his throne. To that I say, wow! Can you imagine at this very moment, Peter on his knees, Paul on his knees, David lifting up his hands. At this very moment, our loved ones who have gone before us rejoicing and dancing before the throne of God. But I also think of David, and David said, I will not give to God that which cost me nothing. This to me speaks of real worship. I think of the priest cutting up one animal after another to give God a sacrifice. By the end of the sacrifice, they are bloody, sweaty guys who had just given their all to God. I think of the Israelites traveling great distances day after day just to give their sacrifice to God. And in the midst of that, I think of what God tells us in the New Testament in the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 13 says, Therefore, let us go forth to him outside the camp bearing his reproach. For here we have no continuing city, but we seek the one to come. Therefore, by him let us continually offer the sacrifice of praise to God. That is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. The thought is, are we willing to bear the reproach to go to him, to go to God? And then in the midst of that thought, the writer lets us know how. Not God's part, but our part. He says, therefore, because we want to go to God, because we are willing to bear the reproach, we offer the sacrifice of praise, the fruit of our lips. Worship will never be about being entertained. It will never be about receiving, though it's wonderful when we do. Worship is about giving. It's about giving our all to God and having a passion for him. It's about fulfilling the greatest commandment and loving God with all of our heart, with all of our soul, with all of our strength, and with all of our mind. Worship says, Lord, I'm going to sing with all that I've got. I'm going to dance with all that I've got. I'm going to lift up my voice and declare my God is worthy. Worship says, I'm not ashamed of my God. That is worship. That is having a passion for worship. May you be blessed as you listen, as you sing, as you cry, as you shout. May you be filled with a passion for worship. Come join us, and together let's lift up the name of Jesus.
Lord, there is none beside thee. Lord, nothing can compare or equal to you. Lord, so this morning with our hearts lifted up and our eyes and our hands, Lord, we worship you and praise you this morning for who you are. And Lord, I ask that our mouths and our voices would be heard. Lord, let the electricity, Lord, that you have given to us flow from our very lives this morning, Lord. Lord, let us lift the hands that hang down. Lord, the voice now still. Lord, for you are worthy. Lord, you are worthy, you are holy, Lord, and pure. And Lord, so this morning our love would flow for you this morning. Overabundant, Lord, love for you. In Jesus' name, amen.
And Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I know I can stand secure. Jesus,
this morning, we can see the holiness of God because He has made us holy. He has died for us. And someday, folks, I know we say this many times, but one day, and I can't wait, to stand by maybe Peter or Paul or one of the great apostles, Moses, Abraham of faith, and to say, Abraham, isn't it a joy to stand here this morning and bow before our Savior? As we practice for what we're going to do in heaven, let's stand this morning because He is holy. And yet, because He's holy and He's just, yet He allows us because He's died upon the cross for us and to just see a glimpse of who He is.
Yeah.
By faith, but on that